There seems to be differences in opinion among BJP MLAs as on Wednesday Marvin Rubish's claim that state might go in for midterm polls, contradicting Michael Lobo's statement. Role of tourism in Goan economy downplayed. Government not giving figures of foreign exchange earned. Needs wider discrimination of tourism policy, says Meet by the Center for Responsible Tourism. Ayush minister blames NGO who had approached the Supreme Court for mining foreclosure. Mum on government inactivity, dump auctions, says mining will resume in Goa. Azad Jamatul Musulmin Welfare Trust alleges CCP is trying to make a garden and a road for a builder in the land belonging to Muslim cemetery in Sakhanis. This is Clinton D'Souza and now the news in detail. There seems to be a difference in opinion among the BJP MLAs. Panchayat Minister Mervyn Godino has rubbished the claims that the state might be going in for midterm polls. This goes directly against what Deputy Speaker Michael Lobo had told GOA365 a couple of days back. Mervyn also said that senior leaders should realize it's high time to behave maturely, otherwise things are not good for them as well as the party, while responding to reporters on the meeting that is likely to take place on Thursday at Mapusa. Here's more. Mervyn Godino on Wednesday asked whether BJP would admit two Congress MLAs into the BJP if it were going for the midterm polls. More people now want to join, seeing overall development taking place, he said, trying to set to rest speculations about the state going in for the midterm polls.
If we were going for midterm polls, we would not have admitted two people from the BJP who willingly joined us. It is not that we forced them. Even now we have a problem of more people wanting to come. Whatever may be said to the contrary, we wanted to rest speculation that we are going for election. And if you ask Congress people, they themselves do not want elections. So who wants elections? That is the first point. I don't think anybody in his right mind would like to burden Goans with general elections or assembly elections in 2 years' time. When it happened in the past, people were very annoyed and they don't want this thing happening. So it is not that we are picking and choosing legislators or luring them. It is they who want to come, seeing the overall development that is taking place. But our leader, who is the chief minister, has a health problem, who is revocating, who is needing rest. So if he is not available to the public, he has to get well first. Only then he will resume his normal duties. Is it our culture to condemn that person, to dump a person once you are sick?
Mervyn also spoke on senior leaders who are planning to meet to discuss the present political scenarios as per MAPSA MLA Francis D'Souza. He said that the revelation in politics was not new. Disgruntlement and dissatisfaction is bound to be there.
See, it is nothing new in any political party. As a political party expands, ambitions rise of different individuals. And it is never the case that any political party you can satisfy somebody 100% and all the leaders. Disgruntlement, dissatisfaction is bound to be there. Some people choose to express it publicly, some people just swallow it for a better day to come. So I would only say this much, when you are senior leaders, when you are mature leaders, it is high time that everybody behaves maturely. Otherwise, things are not good for them as well as the party, which they should ultimately realize. And I think given time is supposed to be the best factor, it's supposed to be a healer. If any hurt wounds are there, they will get healed in due course of time.
It may be recalled that some days ago at function, Michael Lobo has said that Goa is likely to witness midterm polls.
If we are doing something wrong, thoda disani election upaja. And I am still saying that election is imminent. It cannot be changed in Goa with this political situation right now.
You mean the assembly election?
Of course.
Our reporter Hiru Mahale at the Dabalam International Airport. The Congress on Wednesday said that they have still not got any reply for the request for the appointment with the Chief Minister as yet. They also alleged that the administration in the state was at a low time and giving an example for inaugurated emergency care unit and 108, which was allegedly that it was not functional. Here's more. The Congress had requested for an appointment with the Chief Minister after he was back in the state. However, they say that they have still not got one. The Congress has also been alleging that the Chief Minister is not able to administer the state properly due to his illness and the state of suffering.
आमी वाट पळयता म्हणजे ते नरकासुराचो प्रकार तसलोच तो प्रकार 24 तारखेर एप्लाय केला आणि 5 तारखेर नरकासुराच्या दिसात मागीर ते किदें निमित घालून धाडटा तसलोच प्रकार हितूनय आसा हे नरकासूर रुपी जे समाजान आसा ते तेंचो गोबर जावपाक जाय ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन गोंयांत ना ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन काबार जाल्लें आसा आनी त्याच खातीर जी पत्रां बरयता तेका योग्य उत्तरूय मेळना आनी लोकांक सेवाय मेळना
काँग्रेस स्पोक्सपर्सन अमरनाथ पणजीकर सेड दॅट द न्यूली इनॉग्रेटेड इमर्जन्सी केअर अँड द 108 वर नॉट फंक्शनिंग प्रॉपरली अँड द गव्हर्नमेंट नीड टू लुक इन इट
सर्गेस्त जानूस गोंजाल्वीस हाच्या उगडासान ECC युनिट प्रायमरी हेल्थ सेंटर आल्दोना हांगा 27 तारखेर ताचें उक्तावण केलें आनी तें बी एक म्हयनो जाल्या उपरांत आमी तेका जागयलो आनी जागयल्या उपरांत शिटकावणी दिल्ली 2 दिसांची त्या 2 दिसांनी थंयसर सुरू केलें 108 गाडी थंयसर स्टेशन केली आनी ECC युनिटूय थंय चालू केलें पूण ज्या दिसा उक्तावण केलें 27 तारखेर त्याच दिसा सांजचे 108 ही खराब जाली त्याच दिसा आमी आवाज म्हाका कळ्ळें पूण आमी आवाज करूंक ना कित्याक गाडी ती ब्रेकडावन जावंक शकता दुसऱ्या दिसा 28 तारखेर 2 वर्सांचो भुरगो आल्दोनचोच तेका श्वास घेवंक जायनासलो कसलें दुयेंस जालें कितें जालें तें डॉक्टरांक खबर पूण तेका ब्रिदींग करपाक जायनासलें म्हूण तेका 108 जी दुसरी हाडली त्या दुसरे 108 तेका थंय हाडलो आनी तेका ऑक्सिजनाची गरज आसली ऑक्सिजन सिलिंडर आसलो पूण त्या सिलिंडरांच्यान ऑक्सिजन जे त्या भुरग्याक जाय आसलें तें मेळ्ळें ना म्हणजे तो ऑक्सिजन सिलिंडर आसलो तो एक तरी बाबत आसलो नाजाल्यार सिलिंडराक जितले थंय इक्विपमेंट आसूंक जाय ते थंयसर नासले म्हणजे तेका ऑक्सिजन त्या भुरग्याक त्या दिसा मेळ्ळें ना त्या भुरग्याक थंय ECC व्हेलो पूण थंयसर EMT नासलो EMT म्हटल्यार इमर्जन्सी मॅडिकल टॅक्निशियन दोतोर आसलो पूण थंयसर दोतोर कसले हाडून दिल्या जे ट्रेनी आसता कॉन्ट्रॅक्टाचे GKVचे जे कॉन्ट्रॅक्टाचे लेबल नवे डॉक्टर जे आसता ट्रेनी ते डॉक्टर थंय आसा पूण थंयसर डॉक्टर सारके ना मागीर ह्या युनिटांतल्यान तेका परत प्रायमरी हेल्थ सेंटर जे आसा ते OPDन व्हरता पळया दुर्दैवाची गोश्ट OPD आमची पयलींच आसा थंय डॉक्टर थंय पयलींच आसा हें इमर्जन्सी युनिट चालू केलां थंयसर 2 वर्सांचो भुरगो येता थंयसर तेचेर उपाय जायना त्या भुरग्याक आमचे OPDन धाडटा इमर्जन्सी क्रिटिकल केअर युनिट हें सारके अडचणींत चलना आजून पुरायेन 100% तेचें काम पुराय जावंक ना थंयसर स्टाफ जे जावप जाय पडटा ते स्टाफ थंय ना
हांव व्हिडियो जर्नल यशवंत बारापीन पाडोची एवरीबडी टॉक्स अबावट मायनींग बट द रोल ट्युरिझम प्लेज हॅज बीन डाऊन प्लेड ऑल्सो द गव्हर्नमेंट हॅज नॉट बीन गिव्हिंग फिगर्स ऑन वॉट द स्टेट हॅज अर्न ऑर द फॉरन एक्सचेंज अर्न फ्रॉम द फॉरन ट्युरिस्ट फॉर द पास्ट 2 decades These and the reactions to the new tourism policies were debated threadbare on Wednesday. Here's more to the story. The Center for Responsible Tourism held a discussion bringing stakeholders together in response to the government decision to put up a new tourism policy. The feedback is supposed to come from the stakeholders 500 words and by the November 12th. Stakeholders on Wednesday absolutely rubbished this move by the government and demanded that the policy be widely disseminated at the panchayat in local languages and more time give for suggestion.
Aaj amka khub nirashachi gazal manta ti ki itli varsha ami itlo kharch karun sudha goy akhya bharatan 9va kramankacher asa tourism an ami pahilya dusrya kramankacher na Kerala sarki rajya सिक्कीम सारकी राज्यां बरीच मुखार गेल्लीं आसा राजस्थान महाराष्ट्र बी म्हणटकीच आमचेर सगळ्यांचेर जबाबदारी आसा की सरकाराक खंय तरी सांगपाची स्पश्ट गरज आसा की तुमी अश्यो एडवर्टायजमेंट दिवन 500 उतरांनी तुमचे सजेशन्स धाडात आनी मागीर जो मसुदो 21-22 पानांचो ताणी आज इंटरनेटार घाल्लो आसा तो इंटरनेट जांचे कडेन आसा तेच लोक पळोवंक शकतले तो जी राजभास आमची गोंयची आसा आनी सहभास मराठी आसा कोंकणी आनी मराठी ते सरकाराचें ह्या कर्तव्य आसा सामके कर्तव्य संविधानाच्या प्रमाणे आणि राजभास कायद्या प्रमाणे की हो जो मसुदो असा तो जनतेपर्यंत तळागाळापर्यंत ग्राम पंचायती आणि नगरपालिका पर्यंत शिक्षक आणि विद्यार्थी यांच्या पर्यंत कोकणी आणि मराठीतल्यान अनुवादित जाऊन पावपाक जाय. 12 नोव्हेंबर पर्यंत कोण हंगा सगळ्या उत्सवान बी घाई गडबडी नसताना अशा घिसाड घाईन कोण ताजेर अभ्यास करून कसलीच प्रतिक्रिया दिवचो ना, दिवंक शकना. आणि तशें प्रतिक्रिया जर आयल्या ताका कसलेंच म्हत्व उरचें ना. म्हणटकीर जे ग्राम पंचायतींनी हांगा मागणी जाल्ली आसा ही नमूद करपाची आसा की ग्राम पंचायतींनी स्पेशल ग्रामसभा घेवन तांचे कडेन जेन्ना हे कोंकणी मराठीतले मसुदे पावतले ताजेर पंच थंयचे नागरीक आसात ते चर्चा करतले, शिक्षक आसात, त्या क्षेत्रातले स्टेक होल्डर जे आसात, मागीर ते हॉटेलातले लोक आसूं, शेकवाले आसूं, टुरिस्ट टॅक्सी ऑपरेटर आसूं, ह्या सगळ्या लोकांक तातूंत प्रतिनिधित्व जाय. तांकांय बी कितें कितें सांगपाचें आसता. लोकांनी 3 ते 6 महिने सुद्दां मुदत मागिल्ली आसा. लोकांनी स्पश्ट केल्लें आसा की कोंकणी मराठीतल्यान हे भितरीत जावपाक जाय. लोकांनी हेंय मागिल्लें आसा की अशा तरेचे मसुदे जे आसतात म्हत्वाचे जातूंत तांणी सुचयल्लें आसा कायद्यान सुदारणां करतले, जातूंत तांणी सुचयल्लें आसा की गोवा ट्युरिजम डेवलॉपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशनाचेर वेगवेगळे तरेचीं नियंत्रणां येतलीं किंवां तांचें कामाचें स्वरूप स्पश्ट जातलें आनी गोवा ट्युरिजम बोर्ड स्थापन जातलो जो भारतांतल्या खंयच्या राज्यांत आनी संघ प्रदेशांत ना. त्यामुळे असो प्रयोग गोवा स्टेट ट्युरिजम बोर्ड करच्या पयलीं तुमी खूब विचार करचो पडटलो. कित्याक डायरेक्टर ऑफ ट्युरिजम आसा, गोवा ट्युरिजम डेवलॉपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन आसा. फाटलीं 20-25 वर्सां ट्युरिजम डिपार्टमेंट ह्या फॉरेन एक्सचेंज अर्निंगाच्या बाबतींत कांयच उलयना. सद्या ही आकडेवारी आसा 16,000 कोटी रुपयांची. म्हणजे इतलें इनकम गोंयांत 16,000 कोटी रुपयांचें फॉरेन ट्युरिस्टा कडच्यान येता हें गोवा सरकारान दडोवन दवरिल्लें आसा. 27,000 कोटी रुपया गोंयच्या ट्युरिजमांतल्यान जनरेट जाता हें डायरेक्टर ऑफ प्लॅनिंग स्टॅटिस्टिक्स इवॅल्युएशन डिपार्टमेंटान दडोवन दवरिल्लें आसा. तांकां कितल्याशाच वेळा रिक्वेस्ट करून सुद्दां तांणी इंडिपेंडंट स्टडी ह्या बाबतींत हातान घेवंक ना.
हा व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट श्याम चारी इन पणजी. Health Minister Vishwajit Rane said that he will not entertain the representation given by the Market Vendors Association as he would not compromise on the FDA registration.
The Wholesale Fish Market Association traders had submitted a memorandum to the FDA asking that Eva Fernandez be put in charge for checking of formalin in fish and fish be tested at all markets. On Monday, the Wholesale Fish Market Association traders held a public meeting in the capital city where they had made some demands.
I am surprised that the Mr. Ibrahim is making representations of the government and advising the government on who should be appointed in charge of monitoring the fish and imports of fish in the state of Goa. A man who is unable to comply with the FDA guidelines, he has no business to make any kind of suggestions to the government. Any amount of representations given to the government without complying with the FDA guidelines will be put in the shredder and thrown in the dustbin. There is no question of me even conversing or even interacting with a person without these guys complying with the FDA guidelines. FDA guidelines must be complied first and then we can sit down and see how to lay down procedures and guidelines. This man is trying to tell me what I should do. It's my prerogative as a minister and my department and the director as to what steps to be taken and who should be appointed where. No relaxation in the circular issued will be given irrespective of the consequences of that circular. First comes the health of the people, food safety. Both Vijay Sardesai and myself are very firm that international food safety measures must be taken in the state of Goa where food items are concerned. Hence, there is no question of discussing any issue with anyone, whether it's the fish association or any association. Unless they comply with the FDA guidelines, there is no looking back.
Goa 365 Bureau in Panaji. We will take a short break. Stay with us. Panchayat Minister and Dabolim MLA Mervyn Godino on Wednesday admitted that the number of charter flights have reduced subsequently, but domestic tourists have made it up for the loss. Here's more.
Godino was speaking at the sidelines of the commissioning of a new departure gate entry and renovated washrooms in the immigration area at the terminal building of Goa Dabolim Airport. Tourism is the mainstay of the palm frigate state after the collapse of mining industry.
There has been a temporary decrease in the number of charters, but I must say there has been a proportional increase in the number of domestic tourists arriving in Goa. People preferring Goa. I think we have gained, though we would not like, would have liked to gain
we're seeing such things happening. After the tragedy in Kerala, a lot of people, the tourists who used to go there to God's own country, are coming where God dwells. I say Goa is a place where God dwells himself. So we have to keep up good infrastructure.
The AAI Director BCH Negi thanked all the stakeholders, the CIF, Customs, Immigrations, Airlines and others for helping them in modification at the airport. He also added that it was a challenge to carry out the work in a functional terminal building and working simultaneously along with handling passengers there.
Main challenge for our AI team, including the engineers and the other contractors, was to carry out the work in a functional terminal building. We were working at the same time, we were handling the passengers also. See, the washroom we have already seen, it is one of the best washrooms you must have ever seen in any of the airports with the facilities that we have provided. In addition to that, we have started two new gates today. As the Honorable Minister said, we are going to have four gates in future, out of which one gate is exclusively for the staff or the elderly people or the other dignitaries like ministers and MLAs, and three gates we'll have for the exclusive passengers. As of now, we are only having two gates. Because of that, when the peak time is there, we have a lot of congestion in the city side. Already we have very less space in the city side of the terminal. So with these three new gates for the passengers are going to be distributed among three gates instead of two. So the passengers have to wait less time in the queue. Correspondingly, we have got number of CSF personnel also.
Our reporter Hiru Mahale at the Goa Dabolim International Airport.
The blame game continues for mining closure. On Wednesday, the Ayush Minister Sripad Naik blamed the NGO who had approached the Supreme Court on mining. He said that the government will try to resume mining in Goa and the centre is also working on it. Here's more.
The union minister was speaking at the inaugural function of a community hall at Sri Ramchandra Devastan in Katki in Satari. Goa Foundation had approached the court on illegal mining as well as the renewal of leases to 88 mines. On both these, the government was found wanting and to be pulled up by the courts. Also, the government has ore, but the auction has still not yet yielded much results. Our reporter Mahesh Kovekar in Satari.
We will take a short break. Stay with us. The Azad Jamatul Muslimin Welfare Trust has alleged that the corporation of the city of Panaji is illegally trying to make a garden and a road for a builder in the land belonging to the Muslim cemetery in Santanis. The trust says that the land was acquired for expansion of the cemetery by the government, but the land is being sought to be used to build a road for a builder.
Azad Jamatul Muslimin Welfare Trust says the land was acquired by the government in 1981. The trust says the PDA has approved the changes in the plan to make a garden.
Unka compound aur todne ka reasons kya tha? Usko demolish karenge to proof nahi rahega. Fir kabristan ke upar se mitti dalne ke baad mein malum nahi padega kiska kabar kidhar hai bolke. To level hone ke baad mein wahan par 8 meter ka rasta nikalenge taki upar jo builder jo hai usko access road banaye rakhe. Hamara condition hai humko garden nahi mangta. Number 1 हमको गार्डन नहीं मांगता जब 1981 में उस वक्त की सरकार ने बरियल ग्राउंड बोल को डिक्लेयर किया है ऑफिशियल गैजेट्स हैं और जिस आदमी की जगह थी उस आदमी को पेमेंट भी किया है मेरे को उसके डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैं उसको कौन से चेक नंबर से दिया था पैसा, वो भी डॉक्यूमेंट्स है मेरे पास। जब एक्वायर किया गया लैंड फॉर द बरियल ग्राउंड फॉर द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी बोल के, तो तुमको क्या राइट है उधर गार्डन बनाने का?
हमारा जो कब्रिस्तान है 3200 स्क्वायर मीटर, उस जो हमको कब्रिस्तान के लिए दिया गया है उसमें हम चाहते हैं कि हमको गार्डन नहीं चाहिए। तो हमने उसको बता दिया कि 3200 स्क्वायर मीटर है, तो फिर उसमें तुम उन लोगों को क्यों दफना लेने देते? गार्डन की क्या ज़रूरत है? क्या वहीं पे मुर्दे आके बैठेंगे गार्डन में? और बस हम यही चाहते हैं कि उस कब्रिस्तान के अंदर आप गार्डन ना करें। आप मीडिया के थ्रू हम बताना चाहते हैं कि गवर्नमेंट इसमें इन्वॉल्व हो जाए और जो कमिश्नर भी है उससे बात करके बताया जाए कि प्लान को रेक्टिफाई कर करके उसमें से गार्डन वर्ड निकाल करके वो सिर्फ कब्रिस्तान बरियल ग्राउंड ही डिक्लेयर कर दें।
Our video journalist Irshad Sheikh in Panji.
United Tribal Association Alliance has demanded that the government clear the backlog of pending job reservation of the ST, SC and OBC communities in the 80 departments within 15 days. The Tribal Alliance also demanded that the implementation of the Forest Act for the tribal people and a commissioner be appointed.
समाज कल्याण खाते आणि ट्रायबल डिपार्टमेंटाकडून ते व्हेरीफाय करून घेवचं आणि हो रिपोर्ट जो असा ज्याने कोणाक समजा अंडर आय आरटीएस किंवा उठा संघटन जेव्हा आम्ही मागतले त्यांना हो मेळपा जाय, कारण आता सध्या कमिशन नॉट इन पॉवर जो आम्ही उठा ही संघटना निर्माण करतो। सो हो एक पहिलो पॉईंट आमचा जो असलो की बॅकलॉग जे असा जातीत बेगीन भरचे। गोयात 10,000 फॉरेस्टाच्यो जमिनीच्यो केसीस आसात, फॉरेस्ट एक्टा सकट हो जो कायदो आसा तो लागू करचो आमची मागणी आसा, उदाची मागणी आसा, आनी जो आमचो 12 मागण्या पैकी हो सुद्दां एक म्हत्वाचो मुद्दो आसलो की फॉरेस्ट एक्टा सकट ज्यो जमिनी ज्या लोकांक केवळ एसटी खातीरच अशें ना, जेणे फॉरेस्टान 2006 पयलीं उत्पन्न काडलें आसा तो खंयच्याय कम्युनिटी आसा हो फॉरेस्ट एक्टाचो कायदो ह्या लोकां खातीर जातीचे बेगीन लागू जावपा खातीर कितें करपाक येता हेजेर बायोडिझल विशय हो घेवचो।
With that, we have come to the end of this news bulletin. For more news and updates, log into our website at www.goa365.tv. Or even follow us on Facebook at Goa365TV. Download our app on both on your Android and your iPhones to keep watching it on mobile phones. Until then, keep watching Goa365.